Thank you. pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Good evening, class of 2018, friends and family. Before I commence my speech, I would first like to thank all the faculty and staff at Phoenix High School. Without you all, we would be further from achieving our goals, so thank you. To the graduates, we have thrived and kept one goal in mind, which is being here today as a graduating class. To each and every classmate with me today, you all taught me the importance of a community and the friendships that only grow from here. Thank you. We celebrate as not only succeeding as adults, but also a school. I would also like to take the time to thank my best friends, not only for showing me what hard work looks like, but for pushing me through. You guys are the reason I pushed harder. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Brother. We, the class of 2018, embark on a new journey, but most importantly, we celebrate a bittersweet ending of a new beginning. 3 years ago, I attended a Phoenix orientation. We all know how fun those are. 18 and being considered a junior took a toll on me. I was nervous I would not have the determination to finish. Still not optimistic, I came up with a plan B. I went to GTC to look into taking my GED because it sounded like the easiest plan. As months passed, I knew I needed to figure something out. Realizing the importance of using every struggle as an opportunity to overcome any challenge, I started to tell myself, if I came this far, I knew I was smarter to not settle for just the easiest plan. 2 years ago, I began my journey at Phoenix. This time, mine is Plan B. Although not the easiest plan, I finished today with a determination I thought I would never have. Continuing my journey at Phoenix has been the best decision I have made for myself, not only academically, but socially. To the friendships and connections with my teachers, Phoenix continued to bless me, molding me to the person I am today. Nevertheless, graduates, for the adventurous journey that awaits you, I hope it's filled with endless love, happiness, and laughter. Choose your own path, live out your dreams, and face them without buts or what if. Never forget to continue to be the Phoenixes you were all chosen to be. We are not only successful because of our achievements today, but because we achieved it with grit, having the stamina to work real hard and making our futures a reality. Also, remember to use moderation, as one of my favorite teachers would always say. Again, thank you for your part in my journey. Congrats, class of 2018.
Good evening. My name is Donna Scott, and I'm the proud principal of Phoenix High School. I do want to introduce you to some special guests. Please join me in recognizing Ms. Louise Radloff, who is board member from District 5. We think this is Ms. Radloff's 60th graduation. She has not missed a Phoenix High School graduation. Also join me in welcoming Mr. J. Alvin Wilbank, CEO and Superintendent of Gwinnett County Public Schools. Ms. Deborah Dees, Assistant Superintendent for High Schools. And I would be remiss if not recognizing what I believe to be the most outstanding faculty and staff in Gwinnett County Public Schools. Please join me in recognizing the faculty and staff of Phoenix High School. If you will look at your program, we are now going to welcome Ms. Radloff to the podium for remarks, and following Ms. Radloff will be Mr. Wilbanks.
Graduates, Congratulations. I am so proud of you, and you made the right decision. You clearly understood the importance of a high school diploma so that you can move on with your life.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
I recall very vividly the beginning, the early discussions about why we needed a different type of a high school other than the standard high school that we traditionally have. I remember very vividly also a discussion with a young man by the name of Robert Campbell, who was an assistant principal at Parkview High. We had become very good friends, and we had this discussion many, many times. I approached the superintendent, Dr. Cruz, at that time, and my fellow board members. Wouldn't it be nice to have a different type of a setting for young folks who, for whatever the reason, left their home school? There was a lot of discussion, and they agreed that they would pilot it. We tried it at Norcross High, at Meadow Creek, at Maxwell. And finally, they agreed to put it on the ballot for the bond issue for the citizens to address. Sadly enough, it didn't pass the first time around. And instead of blaming the citizens, it decided, well, we need to do a better job to tell the community at large the critical importance of having a traditional or non-traditional high school. We went back to the citizens a few years later, and the citizens approved it. And the Phoenix High that you know today sits there in Lawrenceville, and the second one is going to open very shortly in the upcoming school year. Is there a need? Absolutely. The challenges today within the skilled labor, within the IT area fields, the economics for the future, and so many of the jobs out there today have not even been started or discovered. And these young people tonight who are going to be graduating will have the ability to take the opportunity to go to a technical school or a two-year or four-year college because their families, their parents, they saw the wisdom of getting a high school diploma. I am a firm believer in public education, and I thank the citizens of Gwinnett County for passing sales tax and for passing bond issues in the past. When I came on board to Gwinnett County Public Schools, there were 17,000 children in the district, which was considered a large district by Georgia standards. Today, and we're still growing, it's over 180,000 children. Because of the citizens of Gwinnett moving and wanting and demanding a quality educational system, Gwinnett County has the promise of Gwinnett. The promise of Gwinnett is to meet the needs of our students, to offer the advantages and disadvantages of students choosing of where to go. Whether it's online or whether it's a different type of a school, we are here to serve the public. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for serving and supporting public education. And graduates, once again, the future is yours if you choose. The future is yours. I believe, again, in public education, and I believe in America, even with all of its challenges. God bless America.
Evening. It is my pleasure to be with you tonight. First of all, I want to congratulate these seniors, soon to be graduates, for their perseverance to complete high school and for this night when they receive their diploma. I also want to thank Principal Donna Scott for her leadership, along with her leadership team and this fine faculty and staff that's already been introduced here, for the work you do to make sure that we prepare our students for their future. As Ms. Radloff expressed many years ago when, actually it's probably about 30 years ago, I guess, whenever Phoenix started, and it was the first non-traditional school in Gwinnett. It would attract non-traditional students. I don't know if you know your non-traditional students, primarily because schedules are different. Schedules are different for the day, for the week, and A lot of things are different in terms of the length of the semesters. A lot of flexibility can be offered. But what isn't different? The same quality of education that you receive at any school, you received here at Phoenix. And that's what we appreciate and are proud of. As I thought about tonight, and you know we're starting the graduation season, the school district will have potentially, notice I said potentially, 12,000, about 650 students. Unfortunately, maybe 100 or so of them won't make it, but we hope they do. But in any case, this will be the largest class. And you would expect that as we are a large system and we increase enrollment every year. So you would expect that we have more graduates every year. But the great thing about students today, most of them understand what it is that they need to prepare for, and that is their future. And their future is not our future. My future is probably behind me. Theirs are ahead of them. And we appreciate the fact that they have persevered to this moment. A diploma won't make you a living. Let me repeat that. A diploma won't make you a living. It's sort of a ticket through the door in which you have to, if you go directly to work, then you have to make sure that you perform and you exceed the minimum requirements on the job. If you're going to school, you have to make sure that you continue studying. But it does prepare you again for those things that really prepare you to be successful in life. And one of the things that we all need to be, and that is we need to be successful. Success is defined by a lot of different ways. But I contend if you're happy, if you can make a living, if you can pay your bills, including a mortgage, a car payment, and a few other things, clothes, then maybe you're successful. But I want to challenge you to really be successful in your endeavors and make sure that you not only take care of yourself, but you take care of others. That's the American way. That's what I think all of us should strive to do, and do it with a great amount of enthusiasm and vigor, because this great nation that we're fortunate to live in was not based on a selfish motive of everybody for themselves. I think in society today we may have drifted a little bit that way. But I also think those people that really know what the common good is, you not only take care of yourself, but you help make sure that you take care of your home, your community, your state, and your nation. So graduates, I want to commend you, but also challenge you to do that, because nobody, if you don't do it, nobody will. Thank you. God bless.
Good evening. Thank you. My grandmother would not let me get away with that if I didn't say good evening back. It is my duty, but also a pleasure, to announce the recipient of the Robert L. Campbell Scholarship. The Robert L. Campbell Scholarship is awarded at each graduation ceremony to the graduate that has exhibited the ability and desire to pursue a post-secondary education. I've had the opportunity to teach this student for two semesters. In those two semesters, this student has excelled academically by showing the maturity and the desire to set personal goals and then working to achieve those goals. His efforts were, as I could tell, part habit, but also part a campaign to prove that he could complete the second semester coursework as an independent study course. The next semester, he did just that. He completed the second semester as an independent study course and excelled within this format. He plans to continue his education at Georgia Gwinnett College in the fall, where he will study computer science. I am pleased to present the Robert L. Campbell Scholarship to Ali Ahmad. Congratulations.
Hi, everybody. I would just like to say that these 4 years of high school have not been a walk in a park. They were more like a climb of Mount Everest. Now, if you've seen people on TV climb that bad boy Mount Everest, it was certainly not easy. People have slipped, fallen, and even given up. At the end of the climb, when they have finally reached the top, it is like pure bliss. Can you just imagine the feeling of pure bliss as you look back at the path where you just came from and realize that if you can do this, you can do just about anything. The feeling of overcoming so much to reach your goal. That is how I feel now. That is how everyone here in this graduating class of 2018 should feel. See, just like Mount Everest, everyone will not make it. Some will give in to the pressures. So everyone here, pat yourself on the back. And even if no one is cheering for you, I am. Because I know it can be a hard journey. I know it was for me. I suffered a great loss. I did not lose a family member or a friend, but I lost myself. I gave up on myself when I knew I was capable of doing the work and more. I let outside pressures get the best of me. There were times when I felt like I didn't have a great support system behind me. There were also times when I just couldn't get out of bed. I strayed from my pathway of success. I wouldn't attend classes. I wouldn't do my work because I thought, what does it matter and who cares? I got so behind that when I decided to catch up, it was just too much for me, and I didn't know how to dig myself out of the hole. Now, this isn't an advertisement, but that is when I heard of this school. Phoenix gave me a second chance. Now I'm here, graduating on time with the class of 2018. My teachers were so encouraging, which helped me to gain my confidence back. I learned how to operate on my own, and I was treated as an adult, not feeling trapped. I understand now why the name of the school is Phoenix. Just as a Greek mythological bird, I have been regenerated or born again, in a sense. I went down in the fire and turned into ashes, where I thought it was my point of no redemption. But Phoenix helped me to pick myself back up again and rebuild. I know it sounds cliche, but there's actually a light at the end of a tunnel. You may not be able to see it now, but it will eventually show as long as you work hard. But before I get off the stage, I want to tell you three things that I have learned throughout my life thus far. One. Only the strong survive. This was taught to me by my uncle at a young age. Being strong doesn't necessarily mean physically strong. In order to accomplish a goal and such, you must stay strong-minded. If you are weak-minded, outside influences may try to belittle you or crush you. But you let them know that no one will get in the way of what you want to do, whether it be to go to college or to get a degree of some sort or to own your own business. The second thing is, excuses are tools of the incompetent, used to build mindsets of nothingness. Those who specialize in them seldom accomplish anything great, therefore, there are no excuses. This was also taught to me by my uncle. Even though I knew the words, and believe me, he had us memorize this, I still had to learn this the hard way. I had a lot of excuses as to why I was not able to get things done. A teacher once said to me, Maribe, even though they may be truths, they are still excuses. And to me at the time, it didn't make sense, but now I understand. If everything is planned out and executed as a plan is, then there shall be no excuses. And the third thing is, no matter how hard things get, you must always work hard to accomplish things in life. I learned this lesson from my mom. I obtained this lesson by observing my mother. Although my mom and I do not get along sometimes, she is one of the reasons why I'm here and as smart and strong today. She takes care of my three younger siblings and I, plus her parents, all while owning her own house. She does these things all by herself. She has taught me to incorporate both of the previous lessons of staying strong and not having any excuses. She showed me that no one is going to be able to hold my hand every step of the way, and that I must stay focused and keep going, never give up, and just like the people on Mount Everest, I will one day achieve my bliss. This goes to prove that anyone can accomplish anything in life if you have your mind and heart set out to do it. Last but not least, we have finished high school, and the question is, now what? Well, whatever your aspirations may be in life, I hope that each and every one of you achieve them. Now I wish you all, the class of 2018, a congratulations. Stay strong, ignore the excuses, and stay motivated. And remember, tú eres responsable por tus propias acciones. You are responsible for your own actions. You have accomplished great things thus far. Keep going. We are the graduating class of 2018. Now let's go into the world and show them what we are capable of.
Good evening, family, friends, faculty, and graduates. There's an old Japanese proverb that I believe represents the students of Phoenix. It states, fall down 7 times, get up 8. One of the major things I take away from my experience at Phoenix is the way the school and teachers expect you to bring your very best every day, no matter the excuse. There were times where many of us could not keep to a 3-day absence policy, and many times it was due to things well out of our control. There were early mornings and late nights striving to maintain the grades you needed to pass. There were classes that took more time than others. There were bouts of doubt to whether or not you would be able to do it or where you had the will to do it. It was at times a constant back and forth between struggles of home life and the struggles of school, and sometimes deciding which one garnered your attention more. Whatever your struggle might have been, whether you deemed it a big one or a small one, it was a hurdle you had to jump and an obstacle you had to maneuver. But now, due to your own ambition and drive and determination, you were able to accomplish something that can only make you feel proud of yourself. At times, it was a constant, completely tiring, believe me, but it showed us that success only comes to those who are willing to work for it. I found that Phoenix is an amazing representation of the school. The Phoenix itself is a long-lived bird that rises from its own ashes, the epitome of renewal and perseverance. I commend all of you for these qualities and wish for that tenacity to never die out. Phoenix showed me that life isn't here to coddle you, but people in life are willing to lend you a hand when you are in need. I came to Phoenix simply because I wasn't prepared for what life decided to throw my way. One of the major things I come to realize when you attend Phoenix is that everyone here has a story. Most of you attended Phoenix because your story got complicated and at times hard and riddled with difficult decisions. But now those decisions have led you here to a spectacular ending to your chapter in your lives. You've made it, you've been through the struggle, and I know all of you can make it through more. Celebrate this moment in your lives because you've earned it, and no one can take this accomplishment away from you. I urge everyone, whatever it may be that you do after Phoenix, that you do it with the best of your abilities. Do not settle for anything less than what you believe you are capable of achieving, because the amazing thing about doing your best is that you'll never feel regret no matter the outcome, and you will always be able to say you gave it your all. The past is behind you, the present is now, and the future looks bright and filled with opportunities. I hope that all of you take advantage of these opportunities and honor your own potential. You are now crossing a line into your future, and I'm proud to be crossing it with all of you. This chapter is closed, the page is turned, and there's so much more of the story to be lived. Make it a good one. So now I leave you with this excerpt from one of James Burns' poems. What I've done is who I am, but who I am is what I do now. I won't let up or cease to fight, just this time I plan on doing it right. And what's right lies within me. I'm learning to appreciate my struggle, for it'd be hard to find the joy of accomplishment without it. You live and you learn, you rise and you fall, like the heartbeat of a sleeping giant with bittersweet dreams. Stay up, never down. Thank you all for your time. It's been an honor. Class 2018.
Today brings with it a roller coaster of emotions for our graduates and their families. Tonight is a time to celebrate achievement. Tonight we reflect on a past full of trials and accomplishments. Speaking of accomplishments, on a side note, in 13 years of school, kindergarten through 12th grade, each student has completed at least 18,720 hours of school. Allow that to sink in. As a relative or close friend of the grad, you've already done your job. You've shaped their minds and filled their hearts. Now it's time to take a step back and let them shine. All their hard work has trained them for what is to come. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, my dear seniors. Catch the trade winds in your sails. Explore, dream, and discover. And that is from Mark Twain. Now, Christy Martin and Teresa Perez will join me in presenting our diplomas. Perla Aguilar. Ali Ahmad. Pamela Arajo. Fabian Joel Arias. Jelani Bateman. Maribe Baxter. Richard Bozil. Jalen Birdsong. Christian Brito. Anton Brown. Matthew Brummel. Christian Bustamante. Jose Calderon. Ivan Calero. Jordi Campos Coronado. Julio Cardenas. Alejandra Cardoza. Justin Castillo. DJ Contreras. Gabby Cordova. Nassim Kusar. Dicey Crosby. Deja Edwards. Jose Escobar. Abraham Espinoza. Alondra Gallo. Julissa Gomez. Maite Gomez. Jesus Gonzalez Aguilera. Samara Gordillo. Kimberly Gillen. William Henry. Justin Harris. Camille Harrison. Allison Hanau. Madai Hernandez. Zyra Hernandez. Germani James. Marie Cabilla. Sarah Kempker. Sade Lane.
Jasmine Lindsay. Alicia Lorai. Sally Magana. Demo Mangren. Gennaro Marquez. Rosie Martinez. Isaiah Mascotti. Teresa McFarlane. Cedric McNeil. Michael McRoberts. Gabriel Mendez Morano. Lisa Marie Miller. Cameron Mitchell. Malika Mitchell. Empress Shania Mitchell Robertson. Zaid Obafemi Carpenter. Adrian Oglesby. Jasmine Omoreji. Dulce Perez Jimenez. Clemente Ramirez. Ingrid Ramos. Chase Reese. Iris Resendez. Arlene Reyes Ruiz. Andres Rivera. Honesty Samuels. Grace Sanchez. Kimberly Santijan Gamba. Anahi Silverio Castillo. Erica Spotsville. Shane Sterling. Anthony Sweeney. Sean Sweeney. Kristen Tarver Milton. Elliot Terrell. Eliana Utley. Leslie Vega. Brenda Velasquez. Christina Williams. Carla Zuniga.
The power vested in me from the Gwinnett County Board of Education, I present your 2018 graduates.